বাংলার কবি আর লোককবি বিজয় সরকার। দিস ইজ দা
একটু চতুর্থ দুনিয়া পাবলিকেশন হাউস সম্বন্ধে বলবেন, প্রেফারেবলি ইন ইংলিশ অর হিন্দি।
চতুর্থ দুনিয়া ইজ অ্যান অর্গানাইজেশন হুইচ আর সেট আপ ইন দ্য ইয়ার 1992 আফটার দ্য স্যাড ডিমাইস অফ চুনি কোটাল, এ ট্রাইবাল গার্ল হু ওয়াজ রিডিং ইন বিদ্যাসাগর ইউনিভার্সিটি ইন MSc ক্লাস। দ্য ডেথ রাদার আই ক্যান সে সেলফ ইমোলেশন অফ দ্য লেডি হ্যাপেন্ড ডিউ টু কাস্ট হ্যাট্রেড ইন ওয়েস্ট বেঙ্গল। দ্যাট ইজ দ্য ভেরি লিভিং এক্সাম্পল দ্যাট দ্য কাস্ট ফেনোমেনন ভেরি পার্টিকুলারলি ওয়ার্কস ইন ওয়েস্ট বেঙ্গল। আফটার দ্য স্যাড ডিমাইস অফ দ্যাট ট্রাইবাল গার্ল উই পিপল স্টার্টেড টু লঞ্চ কালচারাল প্রোগ্রাম প্রোটেস্টিং এগেনস্ট দ্য কাস্ট হ্যাট্রেড অর ডিসক্রিমিনেশন কাস্ট ডিসক্রিমিনেশন। অ্যাট দ্যাট টাইম উই ফন্ড অ্যান অর্গানাইজেশন নেম বাংলা দলিত সাহিত্য সংস্থা, অ্যান্ড আন্ডার দিস সংস্থা উই হ্যাড গট অন লিটল ম্যাগাজিন চতুর্থ দুনিয়া বাই নেম টু বি পাবলিশড ভেরি রেগুলারলি ফ্রম দ্য রাইটিংস অফ দ্য রাইটার্স কামিং ফ্রম দ্য দলিত কমিউনিটি, অ্যান্ড ফ্রম দ্য পিরিয়ড অফ 1992 অনওয়ার্ড ইট ইজ পাবলিশিং দেয়ার আর্টিকেলস, দেয়ার ফিলিংস, দেয়ার ইনসাইড ম্যানার্স এটসেট্রা। অ্যান্ড এভরি ইয়ার দিস চতুর্থ দুনিয়া ইট ইজ পার্টিসিপেটিং দ্য ক্যালকাটা বুক ফেয়ার টু শো দেয়ার বুকস, শো দেয়ার পাবলিকেশনস ইন দ্য বুক ফেয়ার ইটসেলফ। এনিথিং মোর ইউ নিড?
Who are the people who mainly subscribe to Chaturtha Duniya, who read it, who discuss it?
Readers are many because writers are Dalits and they are coming with their insight, with their thought, which is not known to other people. Other people, I mean to say the people beyond the Dalit communities, naturally the people who are beyond the Dalit communities, they have got mass of their interest to know all the inner things, what are happening there in the Dalit community. That is the very purpose of the other people. They are coming to Chaturtha Duniya, they are buying it, they are reading it, and they are even discussing about their movement, their writing.
Could you please speak about Sunil Das?
Yes, very sad to tell it to you, we have lost our pioneer movement fellow from the initial. He was with us, Sunil Kumar Das. He was coming from a very, very, very marginalized community, Bauri community of West Bengal, and his residence was at Ashansol of Bardhaman district. From the Bardhaman district and that Ashansol place, he was regularly coming to Calcutta in our meeting, in our movemental org, and participating himself. Very recently we have lost him. We have lost him on 15th of October, just this month. And we, the people attached with this Chaturtha Duniya, had been at his residence on 18th, and we have given some consolation to their, to his children, wife and family members. Just yesterday we have booked on hall in Calcutta to arrange on condolence meeting and on the sad demise of Sunil Kumar Das, and that will happen on 9th of November at Ambedkar Bhavan, Kakurgachi, Calcutta 54.
Okay, could you please tell more about Sunil Das's work?
Sunil Das as because he was coming from a very, very marginalized group of people, he was very much concerned with them. And you will be very much astonished to know that he set up on Ambedkar statue in a very prominent place of Asansol area at the crossing point of Kali Pahari Mod. And that was a very nice statue. And that statue was opened by the prominent Dalit writer. And I myself had been the opener of that statue. And he was coming from the village Charanpur. That is also his own native place. And in Charanpur, he has established the statue of Gautam Buddha. And Buddha's statue, that was opened by Amar Vishwas. At that time, he had been the president of Bangla Dalit Sahitya Samastha. And another particular incident I want to tell to you, that he had opened on library in that Charanpur area named Bauri Land Library. I had been lucky enough to open that library, Bauri Land Library, and most of the literatures regarding the Bauris and even other literatures of the Dalit community people are available there.
Uni ki rokom lekha likhten? What kind of literature did he write? What were the main issues in his literature?
His main issue was about the caste trade, about the neglect of the people, and I can mention on a story, Unfit. He is on main story. We have so far got 4 books on short stories and 3 or 4 books on essays, and his short stories were very powerful. And deprivation, about the deprivation of these people, on short story, just what I was mentioning this time, Unfit. I had chosen this short story to find out the ethics, find out the aesthetics of Dalit literature, and in broader screen, I have focused on the short story, how the Dalit aesthetics are coming in Dalit literature. Very particularly, I have taken few of examples of Dalit aesthetics from his short story, Unfit. How these people, and mainly he has tried to show how these people are being deprived in that area.
So will you talk a bit about Dalit aesthetics?
Dalit aesthetics, you know, mainstream literature, they are having one kind of aesthetics. They are very beginning from the Sanskrit literature, they are announcing that Sottam, Shivam, Sundaram is the aesthetics of the mainstream literature. But we people, we tell that Sottam, Shivam, Sundaram, we are eliminating the Shivam. Shivam is not necessary in our case. It is our aesthetic. Whatever is Sottam, whatever is true, that bears the beauty of literature. And Sottam and this Sundaram, these 2 things are necessary only in Dalit aesthetics, not the Shivam. Because we are disbeliever in that type of God, Hindu gods.
Books of Sunil Das.
Books of Sunil Das, she is having 4 books short story. Yes, some books she might be having. On Kishan, the green.
Should I
take it? Yes, yes, yes.
It's okay, we got it.
Yeah. Art? Dalit, his own short story is Dalit and Adalit. On book of short story is Mukti Golpomala. And Black Dalit, another short story. And the first book, I'm just now not remembering that name. রাজ সভ্যতা বৌদ্ধ বৌদ্ধ আর ধর্মতন্ত্র বাউরিয়া চর বিদ্রোহ ইয়াজ রিটেন অন ভেরি ফ্যান্টাস্টিক ফ্যান্টাস্টিক ড্রামা অন চর বিদ্রোহ and the Chaur Vidroh he has projected there on history, very nice history, that Chaur Vidroh had happened in the 18th century, at the middle of the 18th century, the pioneer, the leader of the Chaur Vidroh, he was coming from the Bauri community, he has projected the character, main character in Chaur Vidroh.
How did he come to you? Like how do you contact Dalit writers? Is there like what we see in mainstream Bengali literature is that there's one established network that is patronized by the main publishing houses. We know who write there and what do they write back. What is the Dalit literature network?
On very nice story behind it, you know, we people, we are writing last 3 decades or 4 decades we are writing. Our writings have been published in various types of journals. But while we are approaching the publishers of Calcutta book market, they are not at all interested to publish any book from the Dalit writers. Naturally, we people had been forced to set up our own publishing corner. And this place where you are just now standing ahead me is Chaturtho Duniya, and we had established this publishing corner in the Calcutta book market in the year 1994.
আর সুনীল দাসের সাথে কি করে যোগাযোগ হলো?
সুনীল দাস অ্যাকচুয়ালি হি হ্যাড গট সাম ইনফরমেশন ইয়েস সাম পিপল দলিত পিপল দে আর ডুইং অল দিস টাইপ অফ লিটারেরি অ্যান্ড কালচারাল প্রোগ্রাম হি হিমসেলফ কন্ট্যাক্টেড উইথ আস অ্যান্ড হোয়াইল হি কেম টু নো ইয়েস উই পিপল আর ডুইং অল দিস জবস অ্যাবাউট দ্য মার্জিনালাইজড দেন হি পার্টিসিপেটেড হিমসেলফ হোল হার্টেডলি বিকেম দ্য লাইফ মেম্বার অফ দিস অর্গানাইজেশন অ্যান্ড our last 2-3 very big meetings we had arranged in that North Bengal in that Rar Bengal area on happened in Asansol, another happened in Birbhum in Bakura district. That happened last two incidences happened there, two meetings happened there.
Also, while speaking about Bengal crisis, while speaking about the organization, can you give us an idea of the other main writers? Also, you have been saying that Dalit writing has been there for 40 years. Could you please tell me the important Dalit writers? What are their contributions to Dalit literature in Bengal and India?
I will show you on book.
Yeah.
Yes, this is the book you can have it. It is written here, Shato Barshet Bangla Dalit Sahitya, 100 years of Bengali Dalit literature. This is the compilation book, 2 years back. We have compiled it. In this book, we have accommodated 83 writers, Dalit writers.
From Bengal?
From Bengal, Bengali Dalit writers, 83 writers we have accommodated in this book, starting from 1911 to 2010. These 100 years writing we have accommodated here, and 6 genres of literature we have included in it. Short stories, novel, essays, autobiographies, dramas, and poems. All these 6 genres of literature we have included in it, and actually what happened, Bengali Bhadrolok people, every time they are propagating it here in Calcutta as well as beyond Calcutta, outside Bengal they are propagating. No, there is no Dalit in West Bengal. They are not writing anything. They are not writing anything. What is there? There is only mainstream writer. That's why this painful job we people have undertaken to collect all these writings. You know, in the year 1913, on voluminous book of poem by Tarok Chandra Sarkar, it was published. We have taken the poem from his book. And from onward, different writers came. And what happened in Bengali Dalit writing, initially those people were writing the poetries only. Afterwards, some people, they have come to write their own biography. One very particular biography I can tell to you, on Dalit fellow. He graduated from Calcutta University in the year 1900 itself. And he came to Calcutta University from a very remote village. After graduation, he was searching for a job. He appeared before an interview board. And the people who were in the interview board questioned him, what your father is doing? Yes, he is a cultivator. He is cultivating the land. Then those people replied him, since your father is a cultivator, you join your father and do the job of cultivation. Why you are searching for a job? See the sad story. One man after graduation, he is being denied a job. This is the sad incident, and they are advising him not to come to job. Advising him what to do? You go join your parents' profession, cultivation. Then what is the meaning of education to them? It is meaningless to them. Those people, by indirect method, they are telling, you need not go to the school, you need not go to college, you need not learn anything. You people do your own job. Be at the place where
you are representing Bengali Dalit writing. So there are many communities among the Dalits as such. It's not a homogeneous entity. There are Namaskudras, there are Pondra Kshatriyas, and there are marginal communities like Haris and all those other communities. So is there any writer from these marginalized communities of the Dalits?
Yes, that is there. It is the very particular motto with us. We people are collecting people from more and more marginalized group of people of West Bengal.
Okay.
You know, we know our one prominent writer is Tulsi Charan Mondol. He is coming from Murshidabad.
Okay.
Murshidabad and very remote place.
Okay.
And he is coming from that one particular community. He is coming from the Chai community. Chai community. Today those people, they collect the rats from the field and they eat the meat of rats. This type of people. And he is a powerful writer. He is associating with us. And this type of marginalized people from the various sub-caste groups of Dalit communities are associating with us.
Okay.
And one particular thing I will be talking to you, because you know in Bengal, initially in our student life we had been some liking towards Marxism or leftism. But what happened that leftism in West Bengal, it was very much oriented and it was working, and all the leadership etc. that had been with the upper caste people. And they were not talking anything or giving any power. I mean everything hegemonial aspects rely on with them only. very recently, some of our friends, Ananta Acharya, he requested me to write an article. And I have made this article, completed it just today. And what I have done there, I will be telling you a brief only of it. I have written this article only on three personalities. One is Dr. B.R. Ambedkar from India. Another is Gramsci from Italy. Another is Mao Zedong from China. These three people, I have discussed them in the light of Dalit historiography. I mean to say, so far the history has been discussed in India, even within the world, you know, there are various schools of historiography. And in India, mainstream historians, they are elitist historians, they have highlighted their contribution only. That is their job. They are coming from the elitist group, they have highlighted their history. And they are known as elitist historians. Afterwards, while this leftism developed in West Bengal, we have got a lot of historians. They came from the leftist thoughts and they have discussed history in some different angles. Not the history of the kings and their domination. They went to the peasant people, they went to the marginalized people, talked about them. And their own group, very latest group, they started on historiography. What I mean to say, that is the subaltern studies. But you know, in India, now another historiography has developed. That is the Dalit historiography. And I have discussed three personalities, Dr. B.R. Ambedkar, Gramsci of Italy, and Mao Zedong, from the point of Dalit historiography. Those people, they have discussed from one angle. I wanted to tell that India, Dr. B.R. Ambedkar tried to this caste phenomenon. He took it as synthesis and he made the anti-synthesis of it. That is the annihilation of the caste. And thereafter he wanted to make the synthesis. What you know, we have got it from Marxism. That is the Dandikota. In Bengali we call it Dandikota. That is dialects. Dialectic. That dialectic, in our view, it has been differentiated from the left historian. We are calling, yes, Dr. Ambedkar, virtually he was a very big communist, since he made the thesis and antithesis, and then synthesis. And Gramsci, he came from a very flowerous community. He was highly educated in university, and all the hegemonial aspects of with him, he detected. If he wants to establish the socialism in Italy, what is needed there? That hegemony is to be broken down. That's why he protested against the hegemony in Italy. Italy, that was his antithesis, and he wanted to risk, but he was put into jail and he could not succeed. Only one successful fellow who have followed the Marxism, in my view, is Mao Zedong. How he succeeded? Because he considered his own country's culture and society. He made the antithesis. Antithesis, what was his antithesis? He took that cultural revolution. Cultural revolution, what he pioneered was the antithesis. And after making that antithesis, he tried to reach to socialism in China. That Mao Zedong, he has become successful. And in my view, through throughout the world, if you go to consider the Marxism, successful Marxist follower is Mao Zedong. In India, Dr. Ambedkar, he has failed because these people, mainstream people, they did not want the annihilation of caste and they did not want to establish any socialism here. That's why what we saw there, they are telling, no, আমরা সমাজবাদ করছি না, we people are not doing socialism. What we are doing something other than, because hegemony will be retaining with them and they will be talking of the Dalits and they will get their votes and they will be in power. We are against these Dalit people and our movement is against this cultural hegemony. We want to break it down.
One last question here. When you are saying about Dalit historiography, so around, for instance, I come from Kerala. Kerala, there has been Dalit historiography where Dalit writers have taken back leaders like Ayan Kali.
Yes, yes. How Dalit historiography has come to light, that is a very crucial point.
So my question was, what are the figures or the history that you have unearthed which the mainstream
especially in Bengal?
In Bengal.
Bangla Dalit historiography,
kemon kore practice? Yes, you know, in Bengal society, these people, they have not, I have told just earlier, I have told that the sad demise of Chuni Kotal. Yeah. Chuni Kotal. After the death of Chuni Kotal, what happened? You know, at that time in Bengal, this leftist government was in power and immediately they set up on commission. We call it Ganguly Commission. And what did they do? Ganguly Commission came and they inquired the matter, and behind the death of Chuni Kotal, caste phenomenon had been there, but they did not uncover it. They just told, yes, it is very natural phenomenon under which Chuni Kotal, Kotal's immolation has happened, or death has happened, we have nothing to tell. And even, you know, Mohasheta Devi initially had been with us, and from the various occasions, she has mentioned in West Bengal, there is no Dalit writer, Mohasheta Devi
host.
And while last year I had been in Pune on Dalit, All India Dalit Writers Conference, after my lecture, a lot of questions are coming before me. They were asking, yes, few days back, Sunil Gangopadhyay from West Bengal came here and gave on lecture about the Dalits of West Bengal. Yes, clearly he mentioned there is no Dalits and no Dalit literature in West Bengal. That is the thing we believe. And I immediately showed them the book, 100 years of Dalit writings. Yes, I have collected 100 years of Dalit writings. Sunil Gangopadhyay is knowing only one kind of history, not the second kind of history, but the before I told it to you. That's why they are denying. They are telling, yes, we people will tell about the Dalits and that will be the Dalit writing. That is their aim, but we are discarding all those things. We are denying all those things. This is their motto. But we people are fighting that situation under the banner of the Dalit Sahitya Samastha. This job we have undertaken. We have now arguing with them. You come and it is the truth to us. What is the truth? If you read on book, you are reading only the mainstream culture and literature. We people, we are reading two books. Because unless we are knowing our own history, the history which you people are not knowing, unless we know our own history, we cannot write. That's why you mainstream writer, you are reading only one book. We Dalit writers, we are reading two books. One from mainstream, another from Dalit writings, and they are focusing. That is the causes behind the movement of this cultural phenomenon, cultural setup.
একটু দলিত সাহিত্য সভা সম্বন্ধে বলুন।
Yes, from the year 1992, while we established this Bangla Dalit Sahitya Sangstha, from 1992 onward, every year Bangla Dalit Sahitya Sangstha mainly organizing 4 conferences within the year. First, in the month of April, 14th April, we are observing Dr. B.R. Sambedkar's birthday. That is on occasion to us, and since we established the organization after the sad demise of Chuni Kotal, we are arranging Chuni Kotal memorial lecture on his birthday. That is on 16th of August. Every year we are arranging it. Okay. Prominent speakers we are collecting from the learned people. They are not necessarily from the Dalit communities who are knowing the sociology, etc. Very particularly, we are inviting them to give the Chuni Kotal memorial lecture. They are coming to give the lecture on the 14th of August. Next occasion, we are doing our annual conference every year, very preferably July or August. And at the end of the year, on 24th and 25th of December, we are arranging our Sangiti. This particular old Sangiti, you know, we have collected this old from Buddhist literature because we believe in Buddhism. That's why Sangiti, you know, it is related with the Buddhism. In the ancient India, you know, 4 conferences. Conferences what Buddhist people told Sangiti. They did not mention it as conference. They told it as Sangiti. Naturally, we people, what we are arranging in the month of the December, we have named it Sangiti after Buddhist literature. And that Sangiti is happening on 24th and 25th. Why we have chosen these 2 particular dates, 24th and 25th? This 24th, you know, 24th December is the day of death of Periyar Ramaswamy Naikar. We are paying our respect to Periyar Ramaswamy Naikar because we know he was a very revolutionary person from southern India. We are giving our whole regards to Periyar Ramaswamy, remembering on that day. And why we are taking 25th of December, you know, that is very particular day. 25th December in the year 1927, Dr. B.R. Ambedkar, he burnt Manusangita in the open place, protesting that was inhuman book. It should not remain within the society. That was his perception. And we people, we Dalit people, who are doing all this literary and cultural movement, we are paying this respect to B.R. Ambedkar, our pioneer in this field.
Apni Periyar-er kotha bollen, you spoke about Periyar. Are there contemporary Dalit writers, theorists, or people who write literature?
Yes, you know.
No, it does. Is Chaturtha Duniya in conversation with people from other places, other states of India?
Yes, we are interacting with the Dalit writings throughout India. Incidentally, it happened. My career started in Nagpur itself at the fag end of 60s. Naturally, at that time, I became acquainted with the Dalit writers of Nagpur, and I had got some personal contact with, say, Dr. Jaswant Manohar, and Nimbalkar. They are the people from Nagpur. These particular 2 people, at that time, I met with them in Nagpur. Thereafter, we thought this kind of movement should be also in Bengal, because the perception what they have adopted in their writing, the same phenomenon are happening in Bengal also from the time immemorial past. Naturally, we should protest it, and from that point of view, we took them as our pioneer writers, and afterwards, you know, Daya Power, Namdeo Dhasal, and Sharon Nimbale, all these writers, they are known to me. They are known to me, and while just a minute.
Pause.